Good morning and welcome to Bay Area Focus. I'm your host, Michelle Griego. We have a very special show lined up for you today. Coming up later in the show, we will hear from an award-winning entrepreneur, an event that shuts down the streets in San Francisco, and a music school located in Fort Mason. And we are starting the show off with some music as well. We are excited to welcome musicians Levi Seacer Jr. and Morty Okin from The Purple Ones, a tribute to Prince. Thanks so much for coming on the show.
Thanks for having us.
Obviously, wearing the purple. Yeah, that's a good tribute to Prince right there.
Yeah, yeah.
Tell me about the band. How did it get started?
I started about 5 years. Yeah, 5 years ago, and had always wanted to do a Prince tribute for a long time. And I was playing in a different band and had kind of wanted to do like a live Prince versus MJ. Show and but we kind of split ways and I immediately figured okay definitely time
so
to
wait
start
a second
Prince
it would have been a show Levi or not Levi Prince versus Michael Jackson.
I kind of want to do a live Prince versus Michael Jackson show.
And who would have won?
Well, who knows?
Who knows?
Prince.
It never came to be. Right, exactly.
Prince would have won.
So you decided to start up this band as a tribute to Prince, and then you meet Levi.
Yeah.
How did that all happen to Levi? I mean, your background, you worked with Prince.
Yeah, I worked with Prince for about 15 years. And, of course, with the passing of Prince, I was grieving really hard. And I never really go out or anything except when I'm playing. And so I got a call, to come play with the Purple Ones. And I'm like, you know what? Maybe I shouldn't grieve right now. I should go play and let all of my emotions out that way. So I never met Morty. And so he invited me to the show, and that's how our relationship began. Yeah.
And what was it like when you started up with the band? Because you actually worked with the artist, and then you're going on and you're playing his music in tribute to him.
Oh, what I liked about the band Morty already had together is that they really dedicated themselves to trying to play the music as it was written. Some people when they want to play Prince's music, but it's kind of complex. There's some layers to it, that's what makes them special. And so the fact that they would take the time to try to do that, I was very impressed with that. So I said, you know what, let me check this out.
How did you meet Prince?
I have so many stories. I try to do the condensed thing. Well, I used to play with Sheila E., who's also Bay Area.
She is.
During that time, Prince would fly out to the Bay Area. And by the way, the Bay Area is one of Prince's favorite spots.
I know it is.
And if you check out the history,
he did a lot of community work in Oakland.
A lot of community work. Mm-hmm. And he donated a lot of money. Also, a lot of the musicians who were part of his sound are from the Bay Area.
Sure.
So anyway, back to the story. So I'm playing with Sheila, and Prince would fly out a lot, and he kind of check you out with the eyelashes. Yeah, you sound pretty good, okay. And I stayed in Sheila's band for about 2 or 3 years. And then when he disbanded the Revolution, he decided to bring Sheila, myself, and the late, great Bonnie Boyer, who's also from the Bay, and he put us three in the new band.
Wow.
Which is the beginning of the new power generation.
Wow.
That's how that happened.
Gosh, so a job of a lifetime. All right, we actually do have some video of your work.
Uh-oh.
So I'm excited to see it. Let's take a look.
I get delirious. Place. So we look on my face. Constantly in a past, pretty much. I just can't wait to race. I get delirious. You get me delirious.
Delirious.
Pause.
One, two, three, four.
Delirious.
This is great.
Thank you.
You started this in tribute to Prince 5 years ago, obviously before he passed. And then when he actually did die, was it more important to you to get his music out there, to honor him?
So I'd been trying to get a hold of Levi for a few years, and he probably thought I was stalking him or something. But
it's okay.
When after Levi and I had talked, and we talked for hours and hours, and it was very apparent that this had to step up. Yeah. And
I think
the rest is
history.
Yeah, I think the other thing, a lot of people, a lot of people come to Prince concerts or whatever, but a lot of musicians was like, what is that sound? How do you get that sound? And when me and Morty talked, I felt like this band would be a conduit for bringing new talent in, because Prince was always about the next thing. So even though we've all cried and grieved, Prince would have wanted us to continue and find the next artist. Who are the new, and I think we're going to present some people at the show next Wednesday. The next ones, yeah.
Wonderful. Yeah, yeah. All right. Well, we can't wait. It's so great. Thank you so much for coming on the
show.
Telling us about the band.
Thanks
for having us. And your performance is Wednesday.
Wednesday the 29th at 10:15 Folsom. And we're doing the Sign of the Times album in its entirety.
Awesome.
Yeah.
10 o'clock.
10 o'clock. All right. For more information on how you can see the Purple Ones live, just log on to purpleones.com. Again, that's purpleones.com. After the break, we are talking with an author who decided to use his personal story to inspire others to be great. We'll be right back.